Hi Pisces, welcome back to the channel, guys. Let's see what your person wants to talk about this week. Who's coming forward for you and what do they want to talk about? For our conversation, we're using Hush Tarot and also feeling pulled to use Allentown Wellness in conjunction with that Hush Tarot. For deeper conversation and clarification, we're using Heaven and Earth Tarot. And, of course, Big Mama Deck. And y'all know I pre-shuffled, so you didn't have to sit through that. If this reading doesn't resonate for you, check out your other sign positions. I also do the extra wild card reading. You can check that one out. See if I pick up your energy there. And this week, for some reason, guys, I'm wanting to remind everyone, you can flip the energies around in this reading. However it resonates for you, use your intuition. Because I really feel like some of the readings I'm getting, where they're either giving me confessions of what they are thinking, feeling, what they've done, or either they're telling me about you. I can't tell the difference. So flip the energy if you need to. See who's coming forward for my Pisces this week. What do they want to talk about? Pisces person. Where's our energy at? My Pisces. Ooh, got one standing. Ooh, and I'm holding the deck upside down, maybe? Yes, I am. Full card. So, that's about trust, faith, taking a leap of faith, new beginnings, things like that. But also can feel risky. Next thing we're talking about is a Knight of Pentacles. Virgo energy. The builder. Somebody's wanting to build something. Got a plan in the head, a strategy. What else? Right here. Ow, the Ten of Cups. Heaven on Earth Bliss card success. Somebody's definitely wanting to build something with us. They're wanting to take a leap of faith. Yeah. Got a plan going on. Being realistic and practical, taking things slow. When we get that Virgo, that Knight of Pentacles, that's a slow-moving progress. Let's pull the Allentown Wellness. Let's see what they want to tell me on the full card. Tell me about the full card. It's from a Pisces person. Tell me about the full card. You're right here. Abundance. Keep a positive mindset. Manifest exactly what you want. Gratitude and bliss. Ew. Good energy. Wanting to manifest something on our Virgo night. The Phoenix energy. New phase. Rekindle. Renew. Transformation. Growth. And changed mind. Somebody's definitely wanting to grow. They're wanting to build something stable. Be realistic with us. They're not wanting to do it in a pushy way. It's a slow moving energy. Let's see that Heaven on Earth. Ten of Cups. Yes, that's bliss. A lot of times we don't get that Ten of Cups energy until we've walked through hell to get it. That's what makes Heaven on Earth so sweet. We've got Cupid's arrow. Oh, man. Have faith. Love is coming. Surprise invitation or meeting hesitation. So we definitely got somebody that is, they're wanting to move forward. They're wanting to move into something solid. And they're, you know, like I said, we're getting the builder. They got a plan of what it is they want. Transformation is what popped on the Phoenix energy. Oh my goodness, that's like sweet energy for my Pisces this week. There was no shadowy stuff in it. What? Oh, I might have jinxed us. Top, knock on wood. Y'all know I'm knocking my head. Because I don't want no shadow. I want it to stay sweet. Let's see what they're going to say. Let's pull the tarot. Let's go. Let's see what they're building here. The Virgo, that Knight of Pentacles, the builder energy. Let's see if they'll share that with us so everybody will know. Ow, Wheel of Fortune, feeling lucky. And y'all know, yeah, I'm holding upside down as usual. What else? Feeling very lucky. Fate, joy, and celebration. Three Cups energy. Oh, it's really good energy, y'all. Victory card, moving forward, feeling like, oh, spotlight. Who's in the spotlight? Tell me who's in the spotlight. Her font. Oh my God. Because sometimes that card for me, you know, it's about loyalty, faith, things like that. But it's also, you know, this person's wanting to build, they want a solid connection with us. It's like, let's call the minister and make it legal. Yes. Oh my goodness. What else do they want to say? Anything else? Let's do their Ten of Cups. Show us your Ten of Cups. Ten of Cups energy. Ten of Cups. Oh, right here. The Emperor. They've got a plan, a rolling factor. They really do. This person is determined. Knight of Pentacles again. Knight of Pentacles. Virgo energy. They're very realistic about this. Taking things slow. They've thought it through. Queen of Cups, because you're the queen of their heart. Yes, you are, with that Cancer energy. And it's, they want to consummate. This is a card of progression. One phase is ended and they're ready to a new beginning, to a whole new phase. You're the queen of their heart. Uh-oh. I love it. I love it. Guys, that's so sweet. Thank you for me knocking on my head on that wood. Because I didn't want no shadow for my Pisces. No. Not with something as good as this. Somebody's in love and they got a plan. They want to move forward. Also, we pulled that the Hierophant. Taurus energy. That's solid. You can trust me. Loyal. Faithful. But then we pulled the Emperor. Emperor energy is divine masculine energy that likes to protect. Yes, the protect bud. I'm your man. Don't let gender throw you guys. I'm going to handle everything. I'll take care of everything. Let's get the messages on that full card. See what they want to say. What do they want to say? Are we going to say something? Yes, we are. I'm at a crossroad when it comes to this connection. Mm-hmm. Crossroad. They want to move forward. They might be a little hesitant because we did get hesitation on the Cupid's arrow about how to actually ask or talk about it. Mm-hmm. I'm hearing perfecting what to say. I can't wait to show you off. I think that was perfect. Yes, I do. Pisces. Can't wait to show you off. Tell the world you're mine. Please try to understand how I feel. Yes. Oh, there's one more. I'm always thinking of you. Let's see what they're going to say on that. Virgo. Knight of Pentacles energy. It's like I said, this person is not jumping the gun. It's something they put some thought and effort into, what they're wanting. July Cancer Leo energy. July. That should bring a confirmation of something for you. Hang on to it if it already doesn't. Keep an open mind right here. Dealing with my insecurities, the negative self-talk is a constant battle for me. Ow, that's just saying, like I said, I'm hearing they want to perfect what to say. I'm afraid of what others may say or think. Ew, that might be some of the hesitation. A little bit of shadow coming with this, y'all. It's calming down, guarded. Their heart's guarded right now. Yeah, or either yours is. Let's see over here on that bliss card, that Ten of Cups energy. Success, Ten of Cups. We've got April, Aries, Taurus. April, July and April in the reading. So, I don't care what other people think. I just want to be with you. But they actually do care what other people think. They're being torn a little bit. Mm-hmm. What else? Is there anything else? Ooh, right here. Flirt with me more. Ooh. Yeah. Flirt with me more. Was there anything else? Not feeling that one. Anything else? Right here. There is more to come for us, but first I have things I need to take care of. Uh-oh. They're trying to make something perfect. Perfect, Pisces. Let's alternate the message deck so I know which side to pull from next. And go back to the tarot. Let's see what they want to bring out. It's from a Pisces person. Let's continue this conversation. It's getting good. I love it, my Pisces. Y'all deserve happiness. Yes, you do. You deserve all the best in life. Because you bring the best to everyone else. What are we talking about? Oh, a Ten of Swords. No, a Ten of Wands. Ooh, Ten of Wands. Ooh. Yeah, it's a wand, y'all. That's burden. Like, I'm under a heavy, heavy load. But a lot of times with, even though it's you feeling like you're taking on too much at one time, a lot of times it's determination. The key word would be determination. I can carry this, like I can get through this because I can see the end result. I can see the village out in front of me. I can carry them 10 wands. I'll make it. Next thing we're talking about is 8 of wands. Body language. Body language. Momentum. Picking up momentum. Getting things to move a little bit faster. But also the unspoken energy that's going on between us. What else? Victory. 6 of wands. Wands, wands. Wands, wands, wands. All down here, y'all. Fire. Motivation. Inspiration. Yes, yes. Let's see what they're going to say. Tell me about the Ten of Wands here. What is that heavy load, that stress right now? Got things I need to take care of. They did say they had things they got to take care of first. And like I said, I was hearing they're trying to perfect something. Here we go. A Knight of Wands, Sagittarius. The mover. Y'all know I'm holding deck upside down. That's the reason it's coming out upside down. Oh, moving towards the absolutely committed relationship. The commitment, that love, that passion. And Sun card. Truth, healing, clarity, happiness. Happiness on that Sun card. What else? You're not telling me the stress. They're telling me the love. Maybe that's what I mean when I say they don't mind carrying a heavy load because they can see an end result. They know what they want. Tell me about that night. What are you moving? Getting things to flow together. Determination. Battle wagon, Cancer energy, bringing in fourth house energy. Possibly creating a stable home, hearth, foundation for us to step into that committed relationship. We got Six of Swords moving away from some storm and getting the victory. They got an idea, a victorious idea, triumph, going forward. And like I said, I'm here, the Cancer, that battle wagon, getting everything, legacy, working on the legacy. 10 of Pentacles. So, like I said, that stress card, they're just doing a lot. They're not saying they're stressed. They're doing a lot. They're handling a lot. They got a plan. Like I said, they've thought this through and they're perfecting something. Something. Let's see what they're going to say on that 8 of Wands. That's the energy going on between you, the unspoken, language y'all got, the conversation that you're not actually putting out words. It's the energy between you. Signals. See what they're going to say about that. Right here. Perfection. Yes, determination, devotion. Devotion comes with that 8 of Pentacles. They're devoted. Like I said, they're trying to perfect something. The idea they have in their head, they're not going to share a lot with that. Moving to a new horizon. We're going to talk about that one. Because that's 10 of Swords. And we've got more movement, and then introspection on the Virgo Hermit. Virgo energy is heavy in this reading, guys, with the Knight up here, Knight of Pentacles. We got two Knights of Pentacles and then the Major Arcana. Somebody's following their inner light. Mm-hmm. Moving towards something. Six of Swords is moving away from storm, moving to a new horizon. We also got a new horizon on the Ten of Swords. We want to talk about that Ten of Swords. Because we did get, I don't care what other people think. There might be outside influences and stuff, others that might have an opinion about us being together that this person is like, no, we're getting past that. Let's talk about that one. Change. Balancing change, acclimating change, fears, what else? Knight of Cups. Tell me, that's our Pisces energy. Knight of Cups. Huh. Is this, I'm wondering if it's our family, our friends, something. But yeah, there's outside, definite outside influences that are naysaying. Uh-huh. Any changes, the changes that this person's going to want to make. It may be triggering some fears for you, Pisces. And then we've got about moving into a committed relationship. I'm worried about what others think, maybe. That Ten of Swords. Friends, family, celebration. It's something, you know, this person's wanting to create joy, celebration. But there's an outside influence that wants to block that celebration, that happiness on this. So just be, pay attention to that. Balance in between it. Let's see what else they're going to say about that Six of Wands. Moving forward, victory, spotlight, energy, Ten of Cups. Is there somebody jealous? I'm hearing like breakout energy. And anytime we get breakout energy, it's when we break out. Our dreams are manifesting. Our dreams are coming true. But then we might have a tribe around us that feel like we're leaving them behind. They're happy for us, but at the same time, they're scared for us to move forward because they feel like, how's that going to change our connection if you go get married and stuff like that? How's that change our connection? That's what I'm hearing. Breakout energy. Uh-huh. Let's see what your person wants to say on it. Oh, that one won't let go of me. Owl to the young emperor standing in a pause mode, considering moving forward. Knight of Pentacles, we might be stalled a little bit. Virgo energy again. Libra, fairness, balancing. We got the Two of Pentacles, and then we get Libra with the balance and the yin and the yang. And we've already picked up there's something about friends, tribe, family, a naysayer that's worried. Sowing new seeds, reward. Tell me about the reward. Things moving fast, rest, recuperation, getting clarity, spotlight energy, victory. Like I said, I'm picking up breakout energy. And it's like things are moving too fast for someone because we're sowing new seed. We're trying to get clarity. We're overthinking things. We're trying to balance on that Two of Pentacles is a balance, you know, balancing the changes, acclimating the changes. And then we get the balance of the Big Mama Libra's justice of what's fair. So we actually, like I said, there's an outside influence. This should be a really, really happy time. But there's someone that's not feeling all that happy for us. Might be worried about losing us. Let's go ahead and pull messages. Let's see what your person wants to say on that Ten of Wands. Ten of Wands. In time, yeah. Like I said, they can see where they want to go, and even though they're doing a lot, it's only for a short amount of time. They're handling things, taking care of things. The thought of you with someone else drives me crazy. You showed me your true colors. I'm hearing it in a good way, y'all, not in a bad way. Mm-mm. Let's see what they want to say on the Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands. The unspoken language we got. You got an intuitive connection with that one because our energies is going back and forth together on an unseen level. We're getting each other. I'm thinking about, oh my God, I'm thinking about making you an offer. Yes. I'm not sure if this is fixable. What are they talking about? The outer influence. The outer influence. What else? Is there anything else on that? Right here. Thank you. Thank you. Let's see what they're going to say on that. Six of Wands. I've been watching you from a distance. You rejected me and it still hurts. Who are we hearing now? Because I'm not hearing the same person. Are they bantering? Are they telling me something someone has messaged you or said to you? I'm worried there's someone else. I know what I want. I want you. Been watching from a distance. You've rejected me. Who is that? So like I said, it's a breakout energy. Somebody is going, no, 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 no. Because you're chasing after your dreams. You're going after what you want. I know what I want. I want you. Ooh. I'm worried there is someone else. What is that? Pisces. Y'all see me pushing up. I was going to go ahead and do our closing messages, but that's got me. That's got me. Let's pull on it. I'm right there with someone else. Tell us about that. Tell us about that. Family, support, honor, respect. Knight of Pentacles, stalling. Thinking things through, reevaluating. Gossip. Ten of Swords, y'all. Gossip. Oh, the breakout energy. Like I said, picking up a breakout energy. Is there actually someone, a friend, or someone in the family telling the person that's wanting to make the offer? Oh, they got someone else. They're talking to someone else. They're talking to someone else. Is that why we're getting the slow-moving energy and the reevaluating? Because there's gossip. This Ten of Swords can also be gossip stuff in our tribe. In our tribe where somebody should be very supportive and happy for us. They're actually stirring a poo-poo pot. Drama pot. Ew. Let's go ahead and get your person to focus in on a deck they would like to give you. A closing message from my Pisces. We're going to get the butterfly deck. Light side of the butterflies. With it. It's from my Pisces. Their person. Final messages, please. Closing messages. I'm so in love with you. I know you are the one for me. I don't know how to prove my love and loyalty to you. Oh, did somebody say to you that they got someone else? Somebody is doing some gossip, y'all. Do you think of me? I feel so torn. I can't get you off my mind. You've changed my life forever. I'm struggling. I'm here for you. Ooh. I pretend like I'm not, but I'm so jealous over you. You're my obsession. Yes. Got two more here. I'm trying to trust that we will be together. Last one, guys. I wish we talked more. I want to tell you everything. I want to tell you everything. Ooh, my Pisces. Okay, guys, that's all I have for us. I'm sending you love and light. Many, many blessings as always. Thank you so much for visiting my channel. I hope I'll see you again next time. Bless me.